Hello, you are now watching The Journal live at Centennial College Story Arts Center. I hope you enjoy what's to come next.
Our show depicts personal documentaries centered around the lives of Centennial College students. On this episode of The Journal, we will be taking a look at the various things our student decided to do during this lockdown, ranging from crazy hot pepper experiment, exercise and well-being, TikTok, dating during COVID, and average student life. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to The Journal. I'm your host, Sara Ovesi.
And I'm Trevoy Damon. On today's show, we will be showing you five documentaries produced by the second-year students at Centennial College. We know how hard the pandemic has been and the restrictions COVID has brought about, but we are here to show you that today proves that despite the restrictions, we still have many freedom at our fingertips.
That's spot on. Our team on The Journal worked really hard on these projects. Also coming up later in the show is our group documentary project about dating during the pandemic. On this episode, I try some of the hottest peppers on the planet Earth, and our producer, Aiden Glassy, investigates the link between fitness and well-being during the pandemic.
Thanks, Sarah. Moving on, let's talk about TikTok. TikTok is a social media platform that has recently become extremely popular among tweens and adults. TikTok was created in 2016, and it's that algorithm that gives users the chance to go viral overnight. Take a look at an aspiring journey to TikTok fame with Forever.
Hi, my name is Forever, and this is a day in the life of me trying to discover internet fame during the lockdown. During this journey, I'll be trying to become a TikTok star within a 4-month span. This is a brief insight into my average day in my journey trying to become internet famous. Welcome. Each day I wake up, I sit on the edge of my bed, let the sun glisten on my skin, and I think to myself, how will this day be different? As I do this, I often remove my skull cap and let my scalp get some air. Helps me think, it relaxes me. But again, I think, how am I going to do this? What to do next? Why aren't I getting any followers? I stare myself in the mirror, hoping new ideas strike my brain. Quite often they do, but sometimes they don't. When they don't, I go for a run. A run on the same Toronto streets of Parkdale, each and every day, striving for new ideas. After this run, typically I enter the studio. It's typically nighttime too. Dark. I like nighttime. It inspires me. We often go to the studio. We create new music. Countercultural music. It helps us think outside the box. We have to bring this energy into our videos. And in these videos, we try and express ourselves the best way possible, through style. But whilst it's still going on, our cameraman Luke must set the lighting to make sure the visuals are looking clean and the stage is set for us to visually perform. And this is when we often pick out our clothing. The style of choice is up to us. Often we go for vintage styles because we find ourselves identifying most with the era. And this is a day in the life of Forever.
Where does Forever plan to take his content next?
From an inside source, it appears Forever is working on creating content specifically designed to promote clothing he's received from brands.
I look forward to seeing his growth. His journey should be fun to keep up with. Next is Aiden Glassy fitness documentary.
I won't lie to you. Ever since the pandemic hit, I got pretty lazy. I've basically been living out of my bedroom for the past year, and over that time, it's turned into a bit of a mess. Clothes and old dishes started piling up, dust started coating everything, and between online classes and the internet being my only social outlet, I started spending almost all of my time in front of my computer. Like a lot of people, I started to struggle really hard with depression and anxiety, especially once winter hit. What didn't help at all with that was when I started to notice my personal fitness decline too. I'd always been pretty lean, but I started noticing my belt getting looser and looser and looser around my waist, and my muscle mass disappearing. It really wore me down every time I looked in the mirror. I'd see my shoulders looking narrower, my clothes fitting loose, and especially my legs looking much weaker than they had in a long time. I grappled with my self-esteem for months as I watched myself deteriorate, feeling like there was nothing I could do. Eventually, though, I decided I'd had enough. I was going to use what I had at home to get myself back in shape. I'll be honest, I didn't really start working out again because I thought it would make me feel better. I had no idea. I just did it because I felt really skinny and weak and I didn't want to feel that way anymore. Even if I'm still trying to catch up to where I was, it feels great to be making that progress again, and it makes me feel less stuck. I think that was the biggest thing, feeling stuck, inside and in where I was and with the lifestyle I was in. Starting to work out again has really helped get me out of that and get me into a more open mindset. I realize that things aren't stuck right now, they're just different. And there are adaptations we can make to fix that or make that feel more normal. For me, it's been finding a way to work out and stay fit, just a different way.
I really liked that one. That was a piece that actually inspired me to pay more attention to my physical well-being.
You can say that twice. I feel like I've lost some muscle mass this year. Do I look slimmer to you, Sarah?
Oh my God, there you go, Trevoy, again about your muscles. You look the same to me.
Oh, thank God no one noticed.
Anyways, did you know people who exercise outdoors and limit their screen times are more likely to perceive their mental health and physical health more highly according to Stats Canada?
I did not know that. Hopefully this new fact, coupled with Aiden Glassy's documentary, encourages at least one of our viewers to take more care in regards to their fitness and well-being.
Yes, and I hope this one does not become too daunting for the viewers to start this change. Remember, the small changes can create a complete shift in your current reality.
Coming up next is Sarah Overseas Hot Sauce documentary.
Yes, it is. About to get hot in here. So grab a drink, sit back, and enjoy this original content. Do not try this at home. Today, my brother and I are going to try something beyond insanity. We'll be trying the hot sauce that everyone loves to hate. The bomb.
Me and my sister have always disputed on who can eat the hottest food. So here we go.
Are you afraid?
Yeah, quite a lot. Okay.
Wait. Let's go. It's definitely very hot.
Yeah.
And it's getting worse as we go. For me, the heat is here. I feel like I'm a dragon or
something. It goes up in my ears too.
It doesn't go away. It doesn't go away. Do not try this at home. Suchtam. And the more time it passes, it gets worse. And worse.
And worse. When you feel it's gone, it's there. It's hiding there.
My stomach hurts. I feel the burn in my stomach.
This is totally insane. Totally insane.
Well, that was pretty self-explanatory.
Yes.
Beyond insanity. My stomach hurts. My lips burns. And I hate you.
Now the heat is kind of pleasant, but I was shaking. I need to rest for at least 2 hours.
Those sauces look painfully spicy. Kudos to you all for being able to hold your spices down. If that were me, I would have choked uncontrollably.
Of course, spicy foods aren't for the weak, Travoy. You better make sure you have your milk and ice handy. That's the trick, you know? Milk, not water, because these spices are oil-based.
Ah, noted. No water, but milk.
Yep.
I'll keep that secret in handy for the next time I have a chili challenge with my mates. Moving forward, let's take it back to the basics with something that is more normal and relatable.
Let's watch Long Mai's documentary about how does it feel to be an international student today in Toronto.
Hi everyone, my name is Jason. I'm an international student from Vietnam. I have finished my program for 3 months and got stuck in Canada. Because the Vietnamese border is closed right now, lockdown get me crazy in the house. Going to grocery now become one of my hobby. I enjoy go on internet to search for new recipe to cook. I can cook cuisine from all around the world now. But my favorite is still Vietnamese food. Living abroad doesn't give me a chance to eat a lot of Vietnamese street food, so I learn how to cook them by myself. But it makes me even more homesick sometimes. Getting stuck here and cooking home food make me feel like I'm slow dancing in the dark. Then I found a new hobby for myself, skateboarding. The weather in Canada become better. I like going to underpass park because the hip hop vibe is hot and also that's a perfect place to practice skateboarding. It's a good opportunity for me to learn some new tricks. I'm still slow dancing in the dark, but in a more optimistic way, because I have more chance to go out, see new people, and enjoy myself.
Being an international student myself, I found Long's documentary very relatable to me, especially during COVID. Prior lockdown, my life was pretty unpredictable, but after the lockdown, I feel my nights and days are pretty scheduled and routine.
Huh. I second that. I found my daily experience, even as a Canadian resident, to be very similar. It's a shame that the spark that drew me to Toronto is no longer there most days.
I get what you mean. Looks like all of us are in the same boat when it comes to day-to-day life during lockdown. But as soon as the vaccine rolls out, we should be able to live a more exciting lifestyle in the months to come.
Coming up next is our group documentary discussing relationships during the lockdown.
We managed to interview a number of couples and see how they're doing during this lockdown. This is an interesting watch.
Toronto, Ontario, a city of over 3 million people and hundreds of thousands of couples. But how have these couples been impacted by the spread of COVID-19? Has it improved their relationships? Has it made them more difficult? Has it put so much strain on them that they're contemplating breaking up? We brought in three couples from the city to answer some of these questions and show you how they've adjusted to dating in a world under lockdown.
You choose. We are in monogamous relationships, ready for a year and a half. No, year and a half, yeah.
It's monogamous.
It's 2012?
Yeah, but on and off. And then we got married.
We do everything together. Now with COVID more.
She has been working more than me recently. Because of the quarantine, the restaurant I was working, it's closed now. So for now, I've been cooking more and doing more domestic stuff because she's more busy. So I think it's kind of fair, right? Like,
I think we talk less because we're always together. Yeah. So we know what's going on, and that's a bit frustrating, and it gets boring sometimes.
Yeah. We have nothing to talk about.
Yeah.
I think the biggest change, it's our weekends, which is basically at home. But
going to the gym?
Yeah, we are not going to the gym anymore. Something that we use it to do together. What else? We use it to travel a lot, to go to places nearby. But this changed a lot. But in terms of stress and daily tasks, I think everything is pretty much the same.
I'm trying to make her laugh.
Yeah.
That's all I can.
Yeah, he tries to keep things interesting with like changing the sense of humor and stuff like that. Activity-wise, we like got into stuff that a lot of couples got into during lockdown. We started cooking together, stuff like that. Sorry if it sounds boring. It's like nothing interesting.
The feelings like, when she come back, what can I do to make her day better? To, you know, I know she will arrive tired. So I like to cook with care for her. And then we set up some nice movie we like to watch, or another day, you know, it's like
disgusting with you.
Instead of going to the gym together, we are working out from home together, and we are watching movies together. Sometimes we call our friends and then we watch movies together with our friends by Skype or by FaceTime.
Yeah, and over time we try to new things, like new food, new something.
Yeah, he knows now how to cook better because he's cooking a lot.
But that's the thing that I think we do. We always keep trying new things, basically.
Maybe I can help him more at home because I'm always so tired when I arrive from work. I'm just like, I want to lay down. I don't want to do nothing. I just start asking things. I need water. I need this. I need that. I think that's what I can do to help him cook, washing the dishes, something like that.
But what I could do to improve, I would say, I don't know, maybe be more patient, maybe be less introverted, I guess.
I think there's definitely room for me to improve on my temper. I get really mad and really feisty at times and just like blow up, which isn't really nice. I regret it right away. Just need to learn to calm down and let a lot of things go.
The capability of letting things go and don't insist on something that I can work on it, yeah. Or maybe I'm gonna be like more patient about things.
We're not as happy people as we used to be when life was different. So when I think you have to be happy to be able to work well in a relationship. And so I think that really has put a strain on the relationship.
Something that we do every day is to be honest with each other. So that's why I don't think that we don't fight or we don't discuss things in a bad way, or we don't like avoid each other by any means. I think that's why for us it wasn't a struggle at all.
We have been feeling this fatigue a little bit sometimes, but I would say that it's more winning than this flaws, you know. It's little flaws comparing to how much we got.
As you can see, these couples have put in some hard work to maintain their relationships, and it seems like it's paid off pretty well. Ultimately, this won't be the case for everyone, as the past year has undoubtedly put every relationship to the test. However, it's comforting to know that it's possible a relationship can weather the storm and join these lucky few.
COVID has really changed the landscape of dating. I can see why the spontaneity in a lot of relationships featured had changed.
Yeah, that's a good point, Travoy. Being at home all the time with your partner can make it harder to keep the relationship fun.
Well, that's all we have for today's episode.
We hope you have a snazzy afternoon and tune again next week for the second episode of The Journal. Bye!
The truth, the money never lie, no, I'm the one, yeah, I'm the one, early morning in the dawn, no, you wanna